In this video, we're going to review contacts at a high level so that users can start using them on purchase and sales documents. So the first thing that we want to do is look at our marketing setup. So I will go into Nav and type marketing setup. So what we need to do is make sure that we've got underneath our defaults, or sorry, underneath our synchronization, we've got a business relationship code set up for customers, and if you're going to use it on the purchasing side for suppliers, you would want to make sure that you've got a business relationship code for vendors as well. So if you do not have one or it's the first time, you can drop down your user list and select new. You could type in vendors. It would show you, obviously, for customers, we've got a contact. Vendors, we don't have any, which makes sense because we're setting up a new one. We could say okay. And now we've got a business relationship code that would be set up so that we can start associating relationships between companies and people so that we can link those eventually to suppliers or customers. And then when we have a contact that we're selecting on a sales or purchase document, it will pre-filter our contact list to only the contacts that exist for that company, for that customer or vendor. Now what we need to do is actually create the contact company and contact customer. So in Nav, you have the ability to be able to create the contacts, obviously, and associate them to customers. But in order to be able to create a contact person, you need to have a contact company. And then that contact company is actually what gets the relationship to the individual customer. So the first thing that we want to do is create a contact company. So I am going to search for contacts. And I'm going to create a new contact. So the number is something that you can allow Nav to assign for you, or you can manually enter it in. So let's just say that this is, we'll say Fastenal. So here, what I'm going to do is just basically fill out the general information. So I've indicated a unique identifier for the company, I've given it a little description name, I've indicated that this excuse me, type is company. The company number just basically defaults from the number that we have up here. I can indicate a salesperson code. So if, for example, there was a certain salesperson that was associated to this contact company, I could indicate that there, or I could leave it blank. The salutation code is something that you can set up if you want. It gets deeper into the relationship management that we're going to go into this video, but ultimately then you can create letters out of Nav and you can indicate on reports a salutation if you'd like. You can put address information in, you can put phone and email information in about the contacts. Under the foreign trade, you could indicate a currency code. As I mentioned, we're just looking at contacts at a high level. So for now, what I'll do is I'll just leave this contact information. Maybe what I'll do is I'll put in a little bit of address information just so that we can see it come in. We'll put some. Information in. And we'll just leave it at that. So now we've got the contact company created, and as you can see, the contact company is bolded in black. And now what we have the ability to do is create the contact people that would be associated to that. So we're going to cover that in an upcoming video. For right now, we're just going to leave this video so that you guys can create your to you can do your setup and you can create your contact people. If you guys have any questions on creating contact companies, feel free to contact us at 519-585-7524.